than Jesus Christ, that whoever accepts him as their Lord and personal Saviour, they will not perish but have eternal life. Hallelujah. It's a free choice to receive salvation. It's not forced upon you. That God gave us a choice to choose him or to choose eternal destruction. If you choose him, you are on the way to heaven in paradise. But if you reject him, I'm sorry to say, but the only place to go is hell. Because everybody that rejects the Son of God as the living God and the Savior of the world, who came and died for us and took our sins to the cross and was crucified for each and every sin of us. If we reject him, the Bible says, we will go to hell with the devil. Hallelujah. So if you want to receive life and life abundantly after this life, then accept Christ Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. But it's a free choice, my friends. We're not here to force you. We're not forcing the gospel onto you. The gospel is a free choice. And man has a choice to choose. If he wants eternal life or death, we have a choice. Just the way every day you make choices, what you're going to eat, what time you're going to go to bed. It's the same way you have a choice to believe in God or not. It's your choice, my friends. But God brought us here to tell you that if you don't repent of your sins and acknowledge him as your Lord and personal Savior, you have no hope of eternal life. Because eternal life is only found in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. We all want to go to heaven when we die. We all think about, there's our loved ones in heaven, we'll meet them there. But I'm sorry to say, the Bible said that Jesus said that I am the way, the truth, and the life. That nobody can go to the Father except by him. Hallelujah. So your good works will not get you there. Nothing will get you into eternal paradise unless you accept Jesus Christ and you make a choice to receive him or not. It's your choice, my friends. Hallelujah. But God has brought us here to tell you the good news, to tell you that he died for you, to tell you that his blood on the cross was crucified for each and every one of us. Hallelujah. That you have a chance to come back to God and have a relationship with your Creator, with the one who created you, with the one who's going to demand your soul when you die after this life. Hallelujah. You have a choice to receive him as your Lord and personal Savior, or you have a choice to worship every other God that you wanna serve. But it's a free choice. God has not forced anybody to accept him. Hallelujah. That's why we're here to tell you that if you want to receive him as your Lord and personal Savior, and you want salvation, and you want to know the truth, and the truth to set you free, then come to the one who came and lived on this earth. Hallelujah. And he came and showed us the truth, and he said that he's the way, the truth, and the life. Hallelujah. His name is Jesus Christ. And you have a chance to receive the one and only true living God, the creator of heaven and earth. The one who said, I am that I am. I am the one who is and who is to come. There's no other God that can claim that they are. There's no other God that can say that I am the one who is and is to come. There's only one man who claimed that he is, he was, and he is the one to come. That man was Jesus Christ. That's why his body did not rot in the grave. That's why he said that he is to come. When he died on the cross, hallelujah, and he was buried in the tomb, his body did not rot in that grave. Hallelujah. No bones of his were found in that grave. He rose up and seated high on the right hand side of God as the King of Kings and the soon coming Savior of the world. Hallelujah. That's why they called him the name of Jesus. That's why they gave him the name Counselor. That's why they gave him the name Mighty God, our Deliverer, our Defender, our Provider, our Healer. Because he's mighty to save. He's mighty to save. And the Bible says that he is mighty to save. That if we come to him and draw close to him, he will draw nearer to us. God is giving you a chance to draw closer to him. Because you don't know what tomorrow holds. You don't know if tomorrow you'll be here or next year you'll be here. God is making sure that every human being on this earth is receiving the gospel, is hearing the gospel, and having to make a free choice of accepting him or not. But I'm telling you, the Bible says that the same way the thief comes in the night when you're not expecting him, is the same way the Son of God is going to come back on the day when we are not expecting him, on the hour when we are not expecting him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's why God is expecting each and every one of us to straighten up, to make a straight path for the Lord to travel. Hallelujah.